Welcome to my channel. My name is Monique Lee, and part one, I made a card, a Happy National Gardening card, and I want to do something else, but I have not prepared what I plan to do, so this is just on the go. I'm gonna put you in the stand. So I had this sticker and I wanted to made it a bit higher so that it's not gonna be one-dimensional. So let's see. I need to find out. I think this is stupid. Okay, so because the glue on the sticker, I'm not sure if it will be sticky enough on this paper, so I just want to be sure. So now I want to use a double-sided foam tape to make, like I said, more lifting up from the card itself. So I'm gonna use this. Right. And put it just in the center. So when you open the card, then it will be written in here, Happy National Gardening Day, and this is a ticket for the entry of a beautiful garden, a city garden. So I made that. Of course, it says here inside, hello lovely, with the beautiful flowers. So this is the card that I made in part one. So now we have to go do another thing, and I think I want to make a flip book. So I have three kinds of pattern paper, and I want to fold this paper. Like this. So as you can see, it's not very straight, but it doesn't matter. So the inside are a lot of hearts, and this pattern paper has this triangular white shapes as pattern, so that's very contrasting colors, as well as this one, very green and yellow, and here yellow and red. So this one I want to fold also. So there it is. So let's see. Will this one fit? Because I know this is shorter. Yes, it is shorter. Wait. I need to follow the lines. I think this is upside down. Yes, this is better. So follow the pictures. It's also well aligned. And this. So I think, wait, oh, it's not straight enough. I need to see where the lines are. So I'm gonna use a ruler and see where it. I believe that's. So I made a fold and I used a ruler for that. So now I'm gonna grab my stapler. And let's try if we can put the middle pattern paper that is short on top and on the side. But that's okay, that's okay. And as you can see, it won't go any further. So I'm gonna carefully fold this. Carefully. Let's see if I can. And then try to staple it. Let's see, is it on the other side also correct? Oh, sorry. I've stapled it wrong. This was is supposed to be on the outside. Well, you know what? I'm gonna take it out. Because of course I need to do it correct. Let's see. Can I reuse it? Let's see if I can reuse it. If I can't, it's not a problem. You know what? I'm not gonna use it. It's not that I cannot fit in the holes. I can't fit in holes. But I'm very picky and I want to do it exactly on the line. So let's do it again. I have to be careful, I don't wanna fold it. Let's see. I want to do it 3 times. And then quickly take it out and bend it back. Because I don't want to have a fold line in there. So, okay. I'm going to put it back, my stapler, where I just grabbed it from. So now, what I'm gonna do is because, like so, it's perfect, but when you fold it, then you see all the papers are not very straight. So what I'm gonna do is correct it by cutting it. Of course, I can use my paper cutting machine. All these paper bits, throw it in my garbage can. Yeah. So is it correct? Okay, now as you know, I don't like corners, so I'm gonna cut every. Have your pen and paper. I'm gonna make a rounded corner. So all the bits, paper bits, I'm gonna clean that up and put it also in the bin. Alright, so now we have to decorate. Some pen and paper is double-sided, but some are not. Like the center is not double-sided, but it's okay. That's okay, that's not a problem. So I'm gonna fold it back because I'm gonna use something to hold. Oh, I think this is more heavier, like this. I wanna show you that I have these origami paper. And I've made some pockets, like so. So what I want to do is I have to make a flap. So let's see. Like here, and then fold a flap like so. So this is the piece that I don't want. So let's make an X so I know that is the piece that I don't want, and start cutting that out. Like so. Luckily I've already prepared and I've put double-sided tape on the sides. So you have to carefully fold it in its place, like so. So now you have this flap, and like I said, I want to have round corners. So I want to do these bottom parts also. So now we have a pocket, it's already to put a goodie in there. So I have this, let's see, stickers, but it won't fit. What can I do? I can fold it, but I don't want to fold it. Let's see if put it aside. This is just a pocket. We made a pocket. Let's go continue. So I've made another envelope, and when you fold it like this, oh, other way around, sorry, left and right first, then the bottom. So now we know lines for. All right, so now this one I did not prepared, so I'm gonna grab my double-sided tape. Let's see. Yes, thank you. Now we have a envelope. I made a third pocket, so I just fold it into the center, and then I've tried to find where it touches the side, so I could fold it over like this, and I made the flap like that. So I made on these parts, I made X's, so I cut it, those parts out. So now I'm gonna take this one I did prepare. I'm gonna take out the double-sided tape and fold it neatly. This also neatly, like so. So now, luckily, the bottom part, I have double-sided tape, and okay. Let's see if we find the stickers that can fit inside. I'm not sure if it will fit. No, that is also not gonna fit, because on this bottom I put double-sided tape, so it won't go further. So what shall we do? We have to fold this. I don't want to fold it. I have to fold it. Okay, let's do it. So the sticker comes from the flow. On a shorter one, so we can put all the goodies, and then let's see, what is the other one? No, I'm gonna lift it out. I'm gonna put it in here. This is the smallest one, like so. And I have also other goodies. Oh yeah, I forgot, I have this envelope. It's from the action. So all you need is fold it. This has a slit here, so you can put the point into the slit. And if you're afraid that it will flap open, so you can put here a sticker in there. So what did I do? While I was uploading part one, I already made tickets with this metal die. So I have from the same flipbook, pen and paper, I made these tickets. So this one is not finished yet. All I have to do is cut. So now it's ready. Let's see. I missed another one. Yes, there you have. Let's see, is everything? Yes, now. Now it's complete. I have six. That's right. Six is in here. I need to find a space. I think I will use this envelope. There it goes. So the problem is, it's not how do you say it, enclosed on the sides, so it can, of course, can fall out, but it doesn't matter. We just put it in here, and let's see if we can find some sticker from this flowbook. Shall I use this purple one? Oh, something fell off. I'm gonna use this purple one. So, and then we put it in here. And then it stays closed forever. I'm gonna take. So, I have not thought about what to put in the front. So, I think by myself, maybe I can find one of these girls. Let's see, what's a good picture for this? This one? Gonna use, so this is just a piece of paper that I've just cut to make the envelope. I'm gonna reuse it. Oh, come on. Okay, there it goes. And put it on the side. Like this. Oh. Wrong side. Like this. And I'm going to choose this girl sticker. Like this. And the rest of these girl stickers I'm gonna put in the envelope. It's gonna do in this envelope. So we have goodies. Let's see. I need to find a quote for this. I don't have a quote. Let's see. Sorry, I'm looking a quote book. So I have these film books from Action, and I need a quote for the first one. So I think, let's see, which one is the best. Be courageous, the wonders will follow. Is this a good one? Enjoy every day of summer. Well, let's see. I love you more today than yesterday, but not as much as tomorrow. This is also a good quote. I'm gonna use this. Let's see. Alright. I'm gonna use a pair of scissors. So I took both quotes because I liked both of them. It says, enjoy every day of summer. I want to put that in the other envelope as a goodie. Let's see. All right. Try to center it like this. Okay. Double-sided tape. I'm not sure if I wanted to use glue stick for vellum, so I'd rather play it safe and use double-sided tape. My whole desk is a mess. But I don't want to clean it up. I only want to clean up the paper bit. So try to do a little bit in the center. And I put a daisy in the corner. So, and of course I want to put everything inside. I have these strips of paper, and I thought to myself, maybe I can make like some kind of corners. Where's my toothpick? There it is. I need to put a hole in the center, but I'm not sure if my toothpick is strong enough. So I'm gonna grab a... I don't have a needle in here. I have here a enamel pin. So I'm gonna use an enamel pin for this. I have to be careful not to break my enamel. Okay. And put, of course, let's see, double-sided tape. Where's my double-sided tape? Oh yeah. Just a little piece. So I have to find the holes back again, so I'm gonna push it through the double-sided tape. Where's the hole?